Hello, welcome to this showcaser introductory tutorial. Here we have a few models representing a bar scene. Let's say we want to showcase this little scene with a nice and simple animation like this one. Okay, let's open Showcaser. We create a new animated sequence. Press Enter to accept the default sequence name or type a new one. Then we select the objects and press this button. It opens a dialog to load and manage the objects of this sequence. By pressing this button, we load the selected objects into the list. The order of the items in the list defines the order in which they will appear in scene. You can use the tools on the right side to rearrange them. For example, by object size, we want the table to appear first, then the chairs, and finally the small objects. The position of the pivot in each object is very important for animation, but you don't need to set it manually. In this case, we can tell Showcaser to place it at the base of every object. Now let's create an entry animation. We define the start and end frame for this animation. Let's just turn on the scale option. Once ready, we press Rebuild Animation. The objects are now magically showing up in scene, one after the other. Showcaser has created all the animations for you almost instantly. We can make it more appealing by adding some overlapping between object animations and a little cartoon-style inertia with the spring option. Now let's rebuild the animation. Nice. Now we can set an exit animation in the same way. It's working, but we see the objects on the table are now floating in the air. That's because the order in which they disappear is the same as in the entry animation. So let's just check reverse animation order here. Great, here's our lovely animation finished. If you want, you can make some final tweaks by adjusting the animation keyframes manually while this check button is active. But be careful, you are not working procedurally anymore, and Showcaser will not remember these last changes if you rebuild the animation. This is for the last stage of the process and more recommended for skilled animators. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. See you in the next one.